ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो। महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाहे कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तद्भक्ताय। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि शिवोर्भक्त हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। I am so happy to again come here in new Braja, that is Braja. Also I am happy to see the devotees here so energetic. Because of Swamiji, very, very far away, about 1,000 miles from India and Vrindavan, how a devotee's village has been established here. I think this is the miracle of His Divine Grace, Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. Not only here, but in the whole world, wherever I went, in West or East, very remote place in Canada, I went there in a very deep forest among mountains. What that place?
Saranagati.
Saranagati. Saranagati. Oh, I become so happy. Varnashram Dharma is there. So many devotees are there. It is only due to Swamiji. I went in Australia in a village remote. Also that place was among the hills. So beautiful. Always raining. Always Basanta Ritu, very far away from India, in East, but there I also saw that very big devotee field, village there, always so inspired there also. women, men, old, very little boys like here, having tilak, kanthi mala, all dancing, all chanting, remembering. Even in India we cannot see like this. Not in India, not so much energetic. But here, everywhere I am seeing. This is miracle of Swamiji, by the mercy of Swamiji. Very remote places from India, he has established all these things. Anyone cannot believe without coming to these places. So I had so much strong faith on him, but when I came here, all the places in West and East, my faith on him become more stronger and strongest. But you should see that in his behind, or the Saplik, Guru Bhakti are there. Śrīla Bhakti Siddhānta Saraswati Goswāmī Thakur, Śrīla Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Prashnadās Kavirāj Goswāmī, Rūpa Goswāmī, Sarūpa Dāmodara Rāya Rāmānanda, and Śrīla Chaitanya Mahāprabhu. Only as a hand he came, what to give? Not his own thing any, but his beloved Radha Krishna and Gaur Nityananda Prabhu mission, especially Sarup Damodar, Rai Ramanand's, Rup Goswami's mission to all these countries. Once I told something, but general devotees could not understand my view. I told that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is himself Srimati Radhika and Krishna. After a long period, anarpiti charing chirat kurunayavatir nahakalo, very long period. After one day of Brahma, about 1000 Kali Yug and all the Yugs coming. After that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. Who was he? Was himself Krishna, but having the beauty and mood of Srimati Radhika, that is combined Srimati Radhika and Krishna, that is Mahabhav Rasaraj. Perhaps you have heard this word. Very special thing in Chaitanya Chaitamrita. As a shape in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan Gaur Hari, he came. In Sri Naudip Dham Mayapur, only to give very, very hidden thing. For Sanakshanandan Sanatan, even from Prahlad Maharaj, for even very mysterious for Narad, Uddhav, that thing, he came to distribute with two hands, not with two hands, lakhs and lakhs hands. All the devotees at that time, there were all hands of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They did not look after the qualification. Anyone, even tiger, even bears, even servants, creepers, trees, who came and saw lovely appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, And they heard calling, "Oh Krishna, where you are, where you are? Oh Radhike, where you are?" All began, devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they began to weep and sing this thing. They have Krishna Prem. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to this. He has not come for establishing Yuga Dharma or to protecting from demons to Bhaksa or for any reason he has not come. Only to establish this. Anarpiticharin Chirat Karunayavatirna Kalu Samarapaitum Unnata Ujjala Rasa. Unnata Ujjala Rasa. He has come only for this thing. What is this Unnata Ujjala Rasa? Unnata Ujjala Rasa is the gopi's mode, especially of Srimati Radhika. Not anything. Only Radhika's mode. How to serve Krishna? For this, he has come. This is of two kinds. The mood of Radhika and gopis, and the mood of the Palyadasi, the maid servants of Srimati Radhika. The Palyadasi of Radhika don't want to serve alone Krishna. If Krishna is calling them, they will not go. So there are two modes of gopis. One mode, like Radhika, Lalita, Vishakha, Chitra and all others. And another mode is of the Palyadasi, the maid servant, especially of Srimati Radhika. They don't want to test Krishna in any way. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to distribute this mode. How Rup Manjari, Lavanga Manjari and all serve to Krishna, Srimati Radhika and Krishna. This mood. Not to give the mood of Radhika. It cannot be given. It is only for Radhika. So he tested. To test all the three moods of Radhika. Radhaya pranaya mahima kitri shobhanayuva Ashwado jena bhutamadhurima kidrishova madhya saukhanchasya madhanubhavatah
kidisam veti
lobha tadbhavadha samajani sachi garbh sindhu. For this one reason. So it cannot, the mood of Radha cannot be given. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not come to give the mood of Srimati Radhika. How he she serves, how she fills pleasure to serve Krishna and to see Krishna, it cannot be given to anyone. But the mode of these gopis can be given. So see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have come to give only this thing. How to serve Srimati Radhika, bending more towards Srimati Radhika, but serving both. He has come to give. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not in this world, Ramanuj, Madhva and so many Vaishnavacharya were there. Before that Ram came, Nrisimhadeva came, all came. They have something, very special thing to give world. But they never gave this thing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and gave Bhakti Rasa. That is called Bhakti Rasa. So Rup Goswami, Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kada Mahiyam Dadati Sakadantikam. There were so many Goswamis, Sarv Damodara Ramananda, but this shloka is especially for Srila Rupa Goswami. Why? Because Sarv Damodara Ramananda were Lalita and Vishakha. Their moods cannot be given. No, not can be given. In any way, anyone cannot give this thing. This is for testing. For Krishna only. So, their guru of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all six Goswamis, Sarv Damodar and Raya Ramananda, guru. Only they have given a special mercy to Rupa Goswami, Sarupa Damodara Ayaramanam, Nityananda Prabhu, all the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu requested them that you should give a special mercy to Rupa, so that he may realize my heart. And that should be given to all whole world. So they all get their special mercy to Srila Rupa Goswami. That is why he has written everything to please Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and only the modes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what he wanted to distribute in this world. None has done this, because especially there was order for Rupa Goswami to do this. So he has done where? In Bhakti Swami Sindhu, in Ujjwal Nilmani. And also he has taken something which was not in Srimad Bhagavata also, or any Purans are anywhere. So he has to compile, he has to write Vidagdha Madhava, Lalit Madhava, and so many books, special books. And from them he quoted slokas for all these things, for Radha mood and all the gopis mood. What is called Braja Rasa. Our old acharyas, beginning from Sarupa Damodara Ramananda up to Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami are our Hindu disciples. None has come to establish Vaidhi Bhakti. None has come for this, to establish Vaidhi Bhakti. Because they are a special acharya. They have not come to preach the theory and mood of teachings of Ramanuja Madhva. They have preached these things. If they are preaching these things, then they should have gone in the sampradaya of Sri Sampradaya, Madhva Sampradaya, Vishnu Sampradaya, Nimbaditya Sampradaya, or any other Sampradaya. So all from Sarupa Damodara to, or from, beginning from Madhavendra Puripad, Ishwar Puripad, and from there up to last, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, our Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj.
Yourself.
They have not come formally to establish Vaidhi Bhakti, but they have preached. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when came, he has come only for distribute that prem, that Braja Bhakti, Braja Rasa. But he has preached Nam Sankirtan also, Yuga Dharma, he has established. Mahavishnu, Narayan, Nisingadev, all the avatars were in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has given mercy to Jagai Madhai, all, so all avatars were in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So at that, any other incarnation of Krishna was not needed. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did it all by himself. He has established Yuga Dharma, he has done mercy to Jagai Madhai, he has fulfilled the wish of Advaitacharya to come very soon. Also he has come to preach and give Krishna prem, also to test the modes of Srimati Radhika. So many reasons there are. But his most two things, to give Krishna prem and to test the mood of Srimati Radhika. Two things were prominent. Because in Chaitanya Charitamrita it has been told, रसिक शेखर कृष्ण परम करुण कृष्ण इज रसिक शेखर यू नो रसिक शेखर बट इज रसिक कृष्ण कृष्ण इज द टेस्टर ऑफ ऑल रसास ही इज ओशन ऑफ प्रेम रस also Ram has some rasa but he is not ocean not unlimited Nrisingadeva has one rasa but he is adbhut when he appeared all whole world was fearful raudra like he has this but Krishna is endless ocean No death, nothing is there, no limit. Krishna. So he is Rasik Shekhar. Well, Srimad Bhagavat was only done for the gopis, glory of gopis, Srimati Radhika. Not for Krishna because so many Purans and everything was there. To glorify Krishna, our supreme object, not Krishna, not Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but their prem. Krishna prem is our object of life. Kansa also had a darshan of Krishna, but he has no prem. So he cannot satisfy Krishna. He cannot serve. So, in Chaitanya Charitamrita it has been told that Krishna prem is supreme object of any jeev. And among them, Radha prem is supermost. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came only to test that and to give the modes of Rup Manjari, Rati Manjari and all Palyadashis of Rika. Jeev cannot digest more than this. He cannot take the mood of Srimati Radhika. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave. And in this way, Srila Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, all संख्यापूर्वक नाम गान्नति कालावसाने कृतौ निद्राहार विहार कादि विजितौ चातंत दीनौ चजौ राधा कृष्ण गुण स्मृते मधुरिमांदेन सम्मोहितौ वन्दे रूप सनातनौ युगौ श्री जीव गोपाल वेरी ब्यूटीफुल श्लोक सो ब्यूटीफुल श्लोक Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all six Goswami, save two, do rolling down on the earth in Vrindavan, somewhere in Radhakund, sometimes in Shyamkund, sometimes in Vrindavan, sometimes in Bhandirvan, Nandagaon, Barsana and everywhere. And calling very weeping, O Radhike, where you are. Doing chanting not less than 1 lakh Harinam with very regard. Observed in thinking Krishna name and Krishna pastimes. Doing lakhs and lakhs dandavat and pranam. Always praying like Hey Radhe, like Krishna Karuna Sindho Dhina Bandho Jagatpati, like this, praying all these slokas, waiting always. So, Srila Rupa Goswami was in the line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, giving only his modes he wanted to preach. From there, Jiva Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Shyamananda Prabhu Narottam Thakur,
Srinivas Acharya.
Srinivas Acharya. And after that, विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर, बलदेव विद्याभूषण, जगन्नाथ दास राधाया प्रणय महिमा कीदृशो वा नैव वा आस्वादो जेनाद्भुत मधुरिमा कीदृशो वा मदीया सौखंचाश्या मदनुभवतः समजनी सची गर्भ सिंधु फदेश मंदिर. So it cannot, the mood of Radha cannot be given. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has not come to give the mood of Srimati Radhika. How he she serves, how she feels pleasure to serve Krishna and to see Krishna, it cannot be given to anyone. But the mood of these gopis can be given. So see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give only this thing. How to serve Srimati Radhika, bending more towards Srimati Radhika, but serving both. He has come to be. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not in this world, Ramanuj, Madhva and so many Vaishnava acharyas were there. Before that Ram came, Nrisimhadeva came, all came. They have something, very special thing to give world. But they never gave this thing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and gave bhakti rasa. That is called bhakti rasa. So Rupa Goswami, Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam sthapitam jena bhutale swayam rupa kada mahiyam dadati sapadantikam. There were so many Goswamis, Sarva Damodara Ramananda, but this sloka is especially for Srila Rupa Goswami. Why? Because Sarva Damodara Ramananda were Lalita and Vishakha. Their moods cannot be given. No, not can be given. In any way, anyone cannot give this thing. This is for testing. First, Krishna Valli. So, their Guru of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all six Goswamis, Sarva Damodara and Raya Ramananda, Guru. Only they have given a special mercy to Rupa Goswami, Sarva Damodara, Raya Ramananda, Nityananda Prabhu, all the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu requested them that you should give a special mercy to Rupa, so that he may realize my heart. And that should be given to all whole world. So they all get their special mercy to Srila Rupa Goswami. That is why he has written everything to please Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And only the modes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what he wanted to distribute in this world. None has done this, because especially there was order for Rupa Goswami to do this. So he has done where? In Bhaktri Samir Sindhu, in Ujjwal Linmani. And also he has taken something which was not in Srimad Bhagavata also, or any Purans or anywhere. So he has to compile, he has to write Vidagdha Madhav, Lalit Madhav, and so many books, special books. And from them he quoted slokas for all these things. For Radha mood and all the gopis mood. What is called Braja Rasa? Our old acharyas, beginning from Sarva Damodara Raya Ramananda up to Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami are his disciples. None has come to establish Vaidhi Bhakti. None has come for this, to establish Vaidhi Bhakti. Because they are a special acharya. They have not come to preach the theory and mood of teachings of Ramanuja Madhva. They have preached these things. If they are preaching these things, then they should have gone in the sampradaya of Sri Sampradaya, Madhva Sampradaya, Vishnu Sampradaya, Nimbaditya Sampradaya, or any other Sampradaya. So all from Sarva Damodar to or from beginning from Madhva, Madhavendra Puripad, Ishwar Puripad, and from there up to last Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, our Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj.
Yourself.
They have not come formally to establish Vaidhi Bhakti, but they have preached. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when came, he has come only for distribute that prem, that Braja Bhakti, Braja Rasa. But he has preached Nam Sankirtan also, Yuga Dharma, he has established. Mahavishnu, Narayan, Nisinghadev, all the avatars were in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has given mercy to Jagai Madhai, all, so all avatars were in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So at that, any other incarnation of Krishna was not needed. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did it all by himself. He has established Yuga Dharma, he has done mercy to Jagai Madhai, he has fulfilled the wish of Advaitacharya to come very soon. Also, he has come to preach and give Krishna prem, also to test the modes of Srimati Radhika. So many reasons there are. But his most two things, to give Krishna prem and to test the mood of Srimati Radhika. Two things were prominent. Because in Chaitanya Charitamrita it has been told, Rasik Shekhara Krishna Parama Karun. Krishna is a Rasik Shekhar. You know Rasik Shekhar? What is Rasik? Krishna is the tester of all rasas. He is ocean of prem, rasa. Also Ram has some rasa, but he is not ocean, not unlimited. Nrisimhadev has one rasa, but he is adbhut. When he appeared, all whole world was fearful. Raudra-like. He has this. But Krishna is endless ocean. No depth. Nothing is there. No limit. Krishna is. So he is Rasik Shekhar. Well, Srimad Bhagavat was only done for the gopis, glory of gopis, Srimati Radhika. Not for Krishna, because so many Purans and everything was there to glorify Krishna. To glorify Krishna, our supreme object, not Krishna, not Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What? Their prem. Krishna prem is our object of life. Kansa also had a darshan of Krishna, but he has no prem. So he cannot satisfy Krishna. He cannot serve. So, in Chaitanya Charitamrita it has been told that Krishna prem is supreme object of any jeev. And among them, Radha prem is supermost. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came only to test that and to give the modes of Rup Manjari, Rati Manjari and all Palyadasis of Africa. Jeev cannot digest more than this. He cannot take the mood of Srimati Radhika. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave. And in this way, Srila Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, all Sankhya Purvaka Nama Gannati Vihikala Vasani Kritau Nidrahar Vihara Kadi Vijitau Chatanta Dinau Chajau Radha Krishna Gunasmrte Madhuri Mandena Sammohitau Bande Rupa Sanatana Rujagau Sri Jiva Govardhana. Very beautiful slope. So beautiful is Lord. Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all six Goswami, save two, do rolling down on the earth in Vrindavan, somewhere in Radhakund, sometimes in Shyamkund, sometimes in Vrindavan, sometimes in Bhandirvan, Nandagam, Barsana, and everywhere. And calling very weeping, weeping, O Radhike, where you are. Doing chanting not less than 1 lakh Harinam with very regard. Observed in thinking Krishna name and Krishna pastimes. Doing lakhs and lakhs dandavat and pranam. Always praying like Hey Radhe, like Krishna Karuna Sindho Dhina Bandho Jagatpati, like this, praying all these slokas, weeping always. So, Srila Rupa Goswami was in the line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, grabbing only his modes he wanted to preach. From there, Jiva Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Shyamananda Prabhu Narottam Thakur, Srinivasacharya, and after that, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Baladev Vidyabhushan, Jagannath Das. But I have so many false ego. So I don't think that myself that I am very wretched person. Then he tells, Dinabandho Jagatpati, I am in this world, but you are Jagatpati. You are the master of whole world. Universe. You take care and support them. So one of them I am. After that he tells Gopesha. You are only Gopesh. Gopesha. Those who are in Vrindavan, Braja, and they are in, I am not in them. You are very beloved of Gopes. But more than that, Gopesha, Gopika, Kanta, more, he is beloved to Gopis, so he is Gopika, Kanta. This name is more prominent. And
most prominent.
Is name Gopika, Kanta, Radha, Kanta. And the last he has done. He is Radha, Kanta, controlled by Radhika. So these names chanting by tongue and remembering the past of Krishna connected with that name. Like Radha Damodar. What you will remember there? Yashoda Ma is binding Krishna in
Ukhal.
Ukhal. Ukhal means
grinding water.
And he is weeping. And Yashoda is chastising and controlling Krishna. Also Damodar is another Damodar. Who? Radha Damodar, controlled by Radhika. So he is Radha Damodar. So, remembering these past times, how Srimati Yashoda controlling Krishna or Srimati Radhika controlling. Remembering these past times of Raja. Being in Vrindavan only, not here and there, where these pastimes were. But if you cannot do, cannot be in Vrindavan, then you can be by your mind, even. But not it will do. There is some more rules. What? You will have to be under the guidance of any Rasik Tattvajna Vaishnava. Being Vrindavan also. Like Rupa Goswami or his Rupanuga Vaishnava. Otherwise not. So, Tannam Rupa Charitabhi Sukritananu Karmena Rasana Manasi Niyojya Tishthan Braje Tadanuragi Jananugamai Kalam Naid Akhilam Ittyu Padesha Sar. This is the most essence of all the Upadesha of Srila Rupa Goswami Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Srila Swamiji has come to give these things, but he has to preach name also, Vaidhi Bhakti also, for unqualified persons. But his most heartily, innermost mood was to give this Krishna prema. I told it in Vrindavan. He was not in the line of Advaita Acharya, Mahavishnu. He has come to establish name. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu established name with prema. This was the speciality. So I glorified Swamiji that he has come in the line of Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami to give this thing, but he has also done this. So he was Rupanuga Vaishnava. So some devotees could not understand, oh, you are not glorifying our Gurudev? He is my Gurudev, not only your. I have divided my Gurudev to you, only to sprinkle some mercy. He was my Gurudev. So you cannot glorify more than me, myself. He has given opportunity to serve him. So I am offering my heartly Pushpanjali in the lotus feet of Swamiji here. He is my Shiksha Guru. You should try to obey all his principles and try to have the most internal motive of Swamiji, and that is Braja Prema, Gopi Prema. This would be object and begin from very lower stage. Anya Vilasita Shunyam, that is sloka. Today I am finishing my class here, offering my dandavat pranam to Swamiji. Seeing that, oh, so beautiful garden is also here in New Braja. So much thanks to you, all the devotees. Glory to all the devotees of Braja, New Braja. One kirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. So, Rupa Goswami's this specialty was that. What he wrote from beginning to end, he realized and then told, like Vyasadeva. He saw everything in his samadhi. And he realized and then he told. Kali Yuga, we don't do. We can steal something from here, from that author, from there. and we will take something and write, and we will take Nobel Prize. Nothing. So we should try to realize what we thought. But as a pun, you can use the teachings of our Gurudev, Shastra, and have very strong faith on this. Now you should come. We have read something. What we read yesterday? No. Are they tired? What we were reading in this book?
Text 5, page 49.
49?
Going to page 50.
We have completed this. This page, 49. Perhaps we are in 50.
50, 51.
He has told the symptom of Kanishtha Adhikari, Madhyam Adhikari, and Uttam Adhikari. Something you can tell about three? You remember?
Yes. In reference to
Kanishtha.
Especially in reference to Kanishtha, Madhyam, and Uttam Adhikari gurus.
Not guru, devotee, simply.
Kanishtha Adhikari, he sees primarily, he has a vision that Krishna, God, is in the temple. And I can see him if I go to the temple only, elsewhere not. And neither does he recognize who is bhakta, who is not bhakta, who is innocent, who is guilty. He doesn't see gradations. So he's lower class devotee.
And madhyam?
Madhyam means he has conviction of the existence of Krishna, God, and sees Krishna and God, but the scriptural backing is not complete. He's not fully learned in the science, not shastravit. Also, Madhyamadhikari, he sees different grades of devotees. He sees innocent person, and to that person he preaches. He sees a guilty or non-devotee atheist, and he avoids that person. He sees his peer as friend, and to that devotee he is intimate and friendly. And then he sees higher adhikari, he sees advanced Mahabhagwat as worshipable, and he serves his every wish. Then Uttamadhikari, he is Mahabhagwat, and he sees Krishna everywhere, and he sees everything happening according to Krishna's plan, and everybody acting as Krishna Bhakta. No discrimination between different levels, only the highest vision of pure devotion. Everywhere he sees that. So beginning Adhikar, Kanista, he can't discriminate because of ignorance. Highest Adhikar, Mahabhagwat, he doesn't discriminate because of pure bhakti. But in the middle, Madhyam Adhikari, he sees the different levels and can discriminate for preaching purposes.
Anything more?
Also, it's explained in Chaitanya Charitamrita according to faith.
Yes.
You can understand the different devotees.
He has described, we will read it afterward.
For the Kanishtha, it stated, Yahara Komala Shada Se Kanishita Krami Krami Tenu Bhakti Hodu Uttama. That his faith is, he has Komala Shada, soft and pliable faith.
What is the meaning of soft? Soft is so good. You know?
Delicate.
Weak.
Yes,
it's weak. It wavers.
Yes.
When one comes in contact with somebody who may present some opposing argument, then their faith becomes weak. But Krami Krami Tenubate Hoibu Utuma, that by proper association, by doing sadhusanga with high class devotees, then Krami Krami, step by step, one ultimately can come to the platform of Utuma. Then next is Madhyam, stated that the Madhyam Bhakti is that his faith is, he has strong faith, but he's Mahabhagyavan, that he's very fortunate.
No.
That Shastra Yukti Nahi Jane, that his
Shastra Yukti Nahi Jane Dridha.
Shastra Yukti Nahi Jane Dridha. His understanding of Shastra is not to the level of the Uttam Mahabhagavat.
Perfectly he does not know.
Perfectly he does not know.
He knows to some extent, knows good, but not perfectly. But Dridha Shraddhaja.
But he's got very strong faith. He's got
Dridha is both. He's not perfectly knowing Dridha, but Dridha Shraddhaja. Understand? Again, what I'm telling you.
Shastra yukti
nahi jane dridha.
So his understanding, he's not perfectly understanding the shastra, but
in other dridha. In other words, he can be defeated in arguments. But his shraddha, his honor to Krishna, his belief on Guru, Shastra and Bhagavan is so strong that he will not give up his worshipping, chanting, remembering or anything. Very established in that.
Dridha?
Clear?
So Dridha Shradhavan, but he's very unestablished, he's fixed up. And
like example?
Example is
Das Thakur was beaten in
22
marketplaces.
But he never told, "Oh Allah, oh Khuda." No. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram. He never. Khanda khanda jadi hai jaya deha pran, if anyone cut me in lakhs and lakhs pieces, I cannot change my these things. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So like Prahlad Maharaj, his Shraddha and his Siddhant established, both were so
strong.
Like this.
So such devotee is Mahabhagyavan. He is greatly fortunate.
And then?
And then the Uttam Adhikari said that he has Prodha Shraddha, that it's deep faith. The Madhyam Adhikari has firm faith, but the Uttam Bhagavat has very, very deep faith, which is fully realized.
Deep faith and second?
Shastra Yukti
Sunipun. What is the meaning of Sunipun?
Very expert.
He has fully realized the Vedic conclusions, Shastra conclusions. He's very expert and he's
realized with realization. And his Shraddha is also so strong.
And he's able to convince all others.
Yes.
By Shastric argument and reason.
Very good. And thirdly, anyone? Anyone? More?
Srila Prabhupada also mentions that sometimes the Uttamadhikari will come down to the Madhyamadhikari platform.
Oh, I'm not asking. It is true. Uttamadhikari comes in middle stage and then he becomes guru. In Uttamadhikari he is always seeing that all are serving Krishna, only I am not serving. So he cannot teach anything. Never. Like Srimati Radhika sitting on the top of Prem and he is thinking, oh, this deer is serving Krishna so much. I cannot. This clouds are serving Krishna. I cannot. Like this. Next way to to distinguish, to establish this. Part 3. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told in 3 ways. We have described 2, but only one you can do. Tell. अरे बैठ करके बोलो. बतला सकता है कि नहीं ये पहले. हाँ तो बोलो. ना ना कुछ नहीं. ऐसे ही बोलो.
Kanishtha Adhikari, yesterday we started that he thought which I am worshipping, that deity is only God.
No, not this.
Janhu Kishanam.
Ki bandh bolo. According to Philly found name, first on Shraddha, depends. According to Shraddha, he is Kanishtha, Madhyam, Uttam. Again, by Srimad Bhagavatam, what he told. Prakrit, Madhyam, Uttam. And thirdly, it depends on chanting of name, especially in Kali Yuga. Those who are chanting only one name, they are Kanishtha. We should honor. Jar mukhe suni ek Krishna. Even he is telling one name. Whether he is Dikshit or not Dikshit, initiated or not, no harm. Second, who is always doing? Chanting always, continuous. These are Madhyam Adhikari. And to whom you will see and Krishna name will come in our heart.
Automatically.
Like Haridas Thakur is going on and all are seeing him and all are inspired to take Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. Only by seeing him, very great personality, his Uttam Bhagavat in this way. Swamiji has told all these things here. So, after that you should read something? One should not accept a spiritual master without following his instructions. Page 52 in last.
One should not accept a spiritual master without following his instructions. Nor should one accept a spiritual master just to make a fashionable show of spiritual life.
What is the meaning? Yes? One should not accept a spiritual master without following his instructions, means?
Without putting yourself at his lotus feet, taking his every word as life and soul, and following with all energy.
Yes.
One should not see the spiritual master as a show bottle, that I have a spiritual master just to show off.
And my spiritual master is so high. So I am also high. This will not do. You'll have to practice and obey him. If you are not obeying, then you are like a soap bottle. We have realized this fact. I am disciple of Mauni Baba. He never speak anything. Only he writes. Or, you know, I am the disciple of Bansidas Babaji Maharaj. Living in a cart, under a cart, not taking anything, taking hookah, because he is in the line of that. No, this will not do. We'll have to practice. Not one should accept a spiritual master to make a fashionable show of spiritual life. Those who have done this, they are bound to fall. Certainly they will fall. They are fallen, not to fall anything new, but outwardly we see that, we will see that in some days he will give up the practice and he will come. Only till of this are taking neck beads, saffron cloths, devotee set, will not do. It adds something, but not everything. Taking all these things and not obeying, they are sahajiya. All these things taking, but not practically obeying the orders of Gurudev, are like sahajiya. He has told before Swamiji yesterday. And then one must be
jigyasu.
What is the meaning of jigyasu? Can you tell a shloka of Gita? Similar? No. Anyone? Yes. You should all know these facts. If you are not jigyasu, then you cannot gain anything. And if you are not serving, you are not thinking about your Gurudev teaching or reading the books thoroughly, any question will come in your mind. If you are thinking so much or reading thoroughly, hearing him, a pariprasna will come. What is the meaning of pariprasna?
No question.
No, not inquire. What is the meaning?
Submissive question.
Having full faith in his guru, after serving him.
Not challenging mood, not arrogant. If I am qualified, if you think that, please explain me.
If I am qualified, please mercifully, you should answer my question like this. Then, to know, why to know? To be established in truth, to realize the facts.
One should be inquisitive to learn from the bona fide spiritual master. The inquiries one makes should be strictly pertaining to transcendental science, jigyasu sreya uttamam. The word uttamam refers to that which is above material knowledge.
Tama. What is the symptom of uttamadhikari? You remember? Uttamadhikari from Srimad Bhagavatam?
Sarva-bhuteshu japasid bhagavad bhavam atmano bhutani bhagavatatman nesa bhagavatuttamah.
What is the meaning?
That sees all entities equal.
He has a
non-dual vision. He's able to see all living entities as parts and parcels of Krishna. He doesn't discriminate.
I could not understand.
He says he sees all living entities equal.
No. Not like this. Here is not anyone is equal, some fat, some long, some. And also that in Vaikunth, there are some ladies, there are some gentlemen, there are some friends, there are mothers, there are animals, cows, not like.
This is
Atmana.
He says within all living entities their relationship with the Supreme Lord. Bhavat Bhavam Atmana.
Go on.
And Bhutani.
What? Don't say.
He says always living entity, the Lord and Jiva.
And what?
He has the highest love for Krishna, and he sees that all living entities have that same love for Krishna, even if they don't have it. Like the gopis saw the trees and the birds and the clouds having the same love for Krishna that they have.
But he thinks I don't have.
Uh-huh.
He thinks also, simultaneously, he thinks I don't have.
Yes. But here's the meaning, like Prahlad Maharaj. He is Tattva-gyani. Krishna is highest Tattva. Advaya-gyan-parama-tattva.
Madanti-tattva-jajgyanam-advayam.
Krishna is Advaya-gyan-par-tattva. Here, devotee who is in Uttam-adhikari, he sees his own deity, worshipable deity, in each
living entity.
And he sees that how I have related to Krishna, all are related in the same way to Krishna. Shlok?
Sarva
Bhuteshu, in all
living entity.
He says, Pashyati Bhagavat Bhavam. The relationship to Krishna.
Like
Atmana, myself.
Bhavam means relationship?
Yes. Bhagavat Bhavam. The bhav of Krishna. What I have relation to Krishna? Same mood. He says, in all. Oh. All are friends of Krishna. And if any is situated in Madhura Shiva, all are gopis. All are serving like gopis, Krishna. Krishna is gopi jana vallabha. If he feels this relation in himself, then he will see everywhere, all are of this. Like a cheater sees all cheaters. A thief sees that all are thieves. A lusty person sees that all are lusty. If brother and sister are going on the same car, very lusty, very wicked person they are going. He will not think that they are going. Mother and son, lover, they are going in this way. So, seeing his own mood to Krishna in all. And second line, Bhagavad Bhama, Bhutani. Bhutani Bhagavati Atmaneshu. In all, he says, he was saying in Krishna that all are related to Krishna in the same mood I am. And here he says in all, the same Krishna is in all. Not clear?
Yeah.
You can clear more?
Yeah.
No, Deep Prabhu. Sarbhute sujah pashyet bhagavat bhavam atmanah. To whom he is worshipping, he is everywhere. Right? He is all the living entity are in Krishna. And next, in all living entity, he sees same Krishna there. First, in Krishna he sees everyone. And next,
in Krishna
he is seeing everyone. Understand something? No?
Yes.
Not clear. What I told. In Krishna, he sees all. And
within all
he sees
Krishna.
But what he sees? Atmani bhava.
His own moods.
Understand now? He is Uttamadhikari. If you have a Uttamadhikari like this, you should serve him fully, giving your head and everything. Krishna bhakti rasabhavitamati kriyatam kutapi jadi labhyate tatra laulyam api mulyam ekalam koti janma sukratir na labhyate. This bhavakti cannot be achieved by only past impressions or in the association of general sadhus, devotees. It will be achieved only by the association of Raya Ramananda, Sarup Damodar, the association of Rupa Goswami, in association of Raghunath Das Goswami, like this. So he has cleared all these things, Swamiji.
45 years.
I am not speaking only here also. Then more you should read. Out of many such Vaishnavas. Oh, where we are?
Right, the bottom of page 52. Tom refers to that which is above material knowledge. Tama means the darkness of this material world, and ut means transcendental. Generally, people are very interested in inquiring about mundane subject matters.
What meaning?
Mundane subject matter?
That can we marry my girl to that person? Can you see my what is in my future? Will I be rich? Something I will be gaining like this. And he has done against me. What should I do? Should I take revenge? What should I do? All these worldly, silly questions. How are you? I'm so well. But you are well? No Vaishnava etiquette, no asking any Vaishnava theory, or I'm so wretched, how I can progress? Now this question. And then?
But when one has lost such interest and is simply interested in transcendental subject matters, he is quite fit for being initiated.
Yeah. What are you telling? Again, you should tell.
But when one has lost such interest and is interested in transcendental subject matters, he is quite fit for being initiated.
What is the meaning?
When one has lost interest in all of the material topics of this world, and he's interested in Divya Gyan, then at that time, he has some qualification for Diksha.
But we see that nowadays, we are not accepting this. Anyone who is rich, very beautiful, or he has come in an aristocratic family, he is so much learned. Oh, come on. We sent any messenger.
Representative.
Anyhow, by crook or
by hook and crook.
Take this person to make devotees, because in future he can help us so much, in so many ways. But this is not okay. In Srimad Bhagavatam, Tasmad Gurum Prapadit Jigyasu, same Uttamam, same thing. Those who want, though who has realized that worldly life is not good, to come across birth and death, sorrow and suffering, to realize Krishna Prem, we should search any good guru. And this is the process. And he is telling. But sometimes we overlook, and that is why the devotees, those who have not interest in these things, they fell down. Even taking renounce order, no firm belief in all these things. So those who have given up worldly desires and all these things, and they want to develop their Krishna Prem or not Krishna Prem, how we can be happy in this world and that world? How we can realize this Atma and Paramatma? So, anyone is qualified to have initiation. Next, go on.
When one is actually initiated by a bona fide spiritual master, and when he seriously engages in the service of the Lord, he should be accepted as a Madhyama Adhikari.
Go on.
The chanting of the holy names of Krishna is so sublime.
Sublime means?
Wonderful. So, high.
Wonderful.
That if one chants the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra offenselessly, carefully avoiding the 10 offenses, he can certainly be gradually elevated to the point of understanding that there is no difference between the holy name of the Lord and the Lord Himself.
He will realize this. We should try to realize. We are conditioned, so how we can realize? We can realize. The spirit to serve Krishna, from where it comes? From where? By the grace of Krishna. Guru comes to us. We cannot go to Guru. We cannot go. So, this spirit comes from Krishna in the heart of Gurudev and then to us. So, Krishna is merciful. We see that so much labor for maintaining life a person has to do. From morning to night, also in night, and there are so many problems. For devotees, Haridas Thakur always chanting 3 lakhs Hari name, no problem at all. All used to give him delicious food, but he takes very little. So much cloth, never he takes anything. So many tasteful things, never he takes. He never looks after. So, we think that there is mercy of Krishna. We are chanting name, and whole world is keeping his head on the my lotus foot. Why? A devotee thinks, it is not due to my any ability, but I am taking Hari name, and so all are serving me, have so much faith on me, whole world is coming. Why? Swamiji, realize this, that whole world is coming. In a very little time, he preached for the whole world. How he preached? Krishna did it. So name and name is same thing. Sometimes the mercy of name is more superior than
Nami.
So a devotee when becomes Madhyamadhikari, he realizes something, little. But as he gradually goes up, he will realize it. So much. Like Haridas Thakur, he was never, Maharaj Durvashari Shivala Maharaj, Amrish Maharaj, he was staying like this. No, not care for death. Death was there, but he was never cared doing like this. Only he was worried for Durvasa, not for himself. And Durvasa, when he saw that death is coming, Chakra Sudarshan is coming, following him, and he played. But he don't knew this fact that this Chakra Sudarshan is everywhere. Where I will go, he will follow. Everywhere he is. He cannot protect himself. Amrish Maharaj knew this fact. Nam and Nami, same thing. So a devotee will realize, then he will not fall down. Always he will stay in chanting name. He will realize pade. Yashe. Cheto darpana marjanam bhav maha davagni nirvapanam seya kairava chandrika vitaranam vidyabhudhi jivanam anandam budhi bardhanam
pati param
sunamadashvatanam. He will realize the mercy of Krishna. And he will see that Nam is himself is divine Krishna. He will play with that name. He will see all the first times in him. Everything. Purunamrita Swadhanam. He will realize all these things. Now, then? Go on.
Yeah. One who has reached such an understanding.
You should all realize this fact. If you are Kanishtha Adhikari, no harm. According to your faith, you should realize something. That he is always protecting Krishna, giving inspirations. So Gurudev has given me Krishna himself. And if he is Madhyamadhikari, sing so many things. And Uttamadhikari saying that Krishna is playing, name is playing, everything is there. Whole Braj is in Nam. All kinds of rush in Nam, all kinds of power in Nam. Nam namakari bhaudha nija sarva shakti stattrarpita niyamata smarani nuka edadrishi tava kripa bhagavan mamapi durdaiva midrisham miha januna. And so beautiful Mahaprasna, himself Krishna, having all the qualities, and even I'm so wretched that I have no taste in me. So try to weep with tears, folding hands, and then you will realize of this. These are the symptoms, process of taking Harina.
One who has reached such an understanding should be very much respected by neophyte devotees. One should know for certain that without chanting the holy name of the Lord offenselessly, one cannot be a proper candidate for advancement in Krishna consciousness.
Swamiji has always encouraged to be advanced. That is, he has told in the one should not remain a Kanishtha Adhikari. So he is telling puna.
Again and again.
He is telling, don't be in one stage. Try to advance. Don't think that Krishna will come. We are the head of the cows assembly, supporting, milking, and serving cows. Only this service will take us to Golok Vrindavan, the highest affection of Radha and Krishna. It can make some
platform.
Platform, that is Sukriti. impression. In gathering this, he will have to associate, and after associates, he will take initiation from guru, authorized guru, and after that he will practice. Then all kinds on earth will go, and then nishtha will come, then ruchi will come, asakti will come, gradually he will develop. But by starting a very bona fide rasik taptagya bhavuk bhakta like Sarup Damodar Raya Ramanand, at once asakti will come or ruchi will come with greed, and it will be due to past impressions, being in the association of very rasik Vaishnava, advanced, then he will have. Then he will not take any ordinary guru, like guru. He will select who is the rasik, who is in our line of Rupa Goswami, he will think. He will not accept blindly anyone. He will think and hear sometimes. And then he will be convinced, then he will associate with him. Their associating is everything. Shiksha guru like, he may take initiation, not even. You know, who was the guru of Sarup Damodar? Who was? He was a Mayavadi Brahmachari, went in Kashi, but he was not Mayavadi Brahmachari. He was the associate of Bal Gaur Chandra. From naked stage, he was friend of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was the inhabitants of Navadvip, very bosom friend of Krishna, Gaur Chandra. He only played a role of that. That he has gone to Varanasi, Kashi, and he has taken initiation from Mayavadi sannyasis, but he was not Mayavadi. We'll have to read all his characters, and then we should decide. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not Mayavadi sannyasi, even he has taken sannyas from Keshav Bharati. He was renowned, very well-known sannyasi of Mayabad. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not Mayabadi. So we will have to consider in all ways. Then?
In Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya 22:69, it is said, Jahara Kamala Shladak Se Kanista Jan Krame Krame Teo Bhakta Hai Bhautam.
We have explained this
today.
Only one stanza you should read. 54 from beginning.
Western countries, people in Western countries cannot concentrate for long periods while chanting on beads. Therefore, the minimum number...
Why he has told that you should chant only 16? Why he has? He is giving argument something. What he is telling?
The Krishna consciousness movement prescribes 16...
No, again.
The people in Western countries cannot concentrate for long periods while chanting on beads.
But they can do 2 hours worshipping, 3 hours, like this. Nothing to meditate or anything. Concentrate. So they can do. They can go on the streets, jumping, singing, dancing, very loudly, very affectionately, as a fashion, they can go. No harm. 24 hours they can go. But then you will tell that this, sit down. Like straight and chant Hare. Don't see anywhere. See everywhere Krishna. And chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. They will tell only 10 minutes after they will see. They are bound to see like that. And if 20 minutes, then like, and they will stand up and say, they will walk something. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And if you are there saying, oh, come on, come on, come on. How are you? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. This is not the process. So he is telling, why he has told? They are busy, very busy, 14 busy, making so many things, making money, making all these things. They are making bombs to destroy whole world in a second. They are so much busy.
Therefore, the minimum number of rounds is prescribed. However, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say that unless one chants at least 64 rounds of japa, 100,000 names.
100,000 rounds.
Oh, names.
Then
he is considered fallen.
Yes. Krishna did not take any offering. He will not take. So we should do qualified names. Oh Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, like this. Where is my beloved Krishna? Where is Nanda Nanda? Where is Yashoda Nanda? Where is Radharaman? And waiting, chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Seeing Krishna somewhere in bushes and at once runs to catch hold of Krishna. But Krishna is so naughty, he goes, he goes 1-2 feet behind, and sometimes here and there. And when he comes so near, then he disappears. And he fell floor suddenly. Earth rolling down, oh Krishna, very well, very good. In this way, and Krishna will certainly come. This is the process he has taught.
According to his calculation, practically every one of us is fallen. But because we are trying...
Because apparently after some days we see that he has fallen, he has left Harinam. He has napped all these things, activities, and involved in all these things. Someone who has got tolerance, they will never give up. Gradually they will develop. They will do 16, after that 32, after that 45, 48, after that 64. They will not be satisfied by these. They will try to chant 2 lakhs, after 3 lakhs. After that, very pure name, Shuddha name. This is the process of doing that. So he is telling.
But because we are trying to serve the Supreme Lord with all seriousness and without duplicity, we can expect the mercy of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is famous as Patita Pavana, the deliverer of the fallen.
The thing is that he realizes our position. So he has given some concession to us, especially to Western devotees, because they are so engaged in worldly things. So he has given a trap. Trap means jal?
Trap.
Lovely trap. That if you will chant 16 rounds even, you will go to. You will be happy here and there, everything. It is like a trap world. After that he will have himself some taste and nothing to tell anything. He will gradually develop. And even he is completing 3 lakhs, he will not be satisfied. Oh, there is no Krishna praying. Always weeping, lamenting and praying. Nenangaladashudharaya badanangadagadaruddhaya gira ulikarni chitang bapuhakada tamanama grahane kada bhavishyati. And he can tell like that. गंधोस्ति दरापि मे हरौ क्रन्दामि सौभाग्यभरं प्रकाशितम् वंशे विलास्याननवलोकनं विना विभर्त्मजत् प्राण पतंग कामता. Oh, I have not a little smell of prem. Fishes, those who are taken out of water, at once they die without water. So I am not seeing my beloved Krishna, and still I am alive. Dhikmam, fight on me. Thus they go on chanting and remembering. Gaur Pramana. Mahamantra.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Swamiji used to tell me, request me, oh, you should drink. Now it is choked. I cannot do according to, due to my old age. But that time I used to sing so high.